What are you looking out for this coming weekend against Maine?
We're a team that is constantly looking to reinvent ourselves, kind of find our finish line. We haven't got there yet. We're looking for that elusive first win. There's no easy teams in Hockey East. You know, teams might think that's us. We like that. We like people to think that we're an easy mark. So we know that Maine is a really big, really strong, hard, heavy team. That kind of lends itself to our identity of what we want to do. We know that when we get that first win, hopefully it's this weekend, hopefully it's on Friday, that all the work that we've done ahead of time has been fueling to get towards that win. And then when we get that win, it's going to be building off of what we just did. So this is a nonstop journey for this team here. You know, we're trying to make our players understand the difference between being tight and tentative, which we were a little bit in the second game against Providence, versus loose and driving, which was the first game against Providence, which I felt was our best game of the year. I think anybody watching would say that as well. And even our first period of the second game, and then just a few young mistakes. So we're looking against Maine this weekend to eliminate those mistakes. We're certainly not a team that can afford to capitalize on those or let other teams capitalize against our mistakes. We need to be a team that's real hard to play against. It's comfortable in those 1-0 games. And you know, frankly, even in the first Providence game there, we have a goal that's called back on an early whistle. It's a 1-0 game. We have a penalty that probably should have been a penalty shot at the end of the game. And maybe that's a different seven in a game. And even in the second game there, a puck goes into the netting and we can't blame the officials because they couldn't prove it. But we're searching for this identity. We're slowly getting there. And I think against Maine this weekend, we're going to be able to reveal it a little bit better.
And before I let you go with Dovar, who's going to be talking in a moment, how would you describe his acclimation to college hockey, and particularly knowing what the makeup of Maine is coming up this weekend? A guy, you know, his maturity relative to theirs, what does he have to be mindful of? How does that work?
Well, he'll be coming in a couple minutes here, and I'm pretty sure you guys are going to be very impressed with Dovar. This is a 17-year-old young man. I know when I was 17, I certainly wasn't in front of a media screen dealing with questions from professionals. His maturity is way beyond his years. So part of our job is to field phone calls from NHL teams. I've had 16 or 17 reach out since the season started about Dovar, and I tell them all the exact same thing. It's not even going to be a secret. This is a young man who is miles ahead of any 17-year-old that I've ever been around. And certainly when I was 17 years old, I wasn't maintaining the poise that Dovar has as a person first. As a person, he is responsible. He's kind. He's well-liked by his teammates. He puts in the work. He's embraced how hard it is to be playing in this league against people who are 7 years older than him. Like, there's guys on this team that are going to have a mortgage next year. It's a big thing for a 17-year-old to know that his line mates, he's going to be a best man in their wedding in a year or 2 years. So it's to see his evolution, even in the 16 weeks or so that we've been together, has been awesome. And then you look at his on-game product. So he came in as a highly offensive player, very, very skilled young man. And then he made the choice to come here instead of just taking the route to go and play in juniors and be an offensive juggernaut. He understood that his game will evolve into being a professional if he plays against the best, if he plays against people who are 6-7 years older than him, 5 years older than him all the time. Because when he does get to the NHL, and I'm certain this is a young man who will be in the NHL, we'll all be watching him on TV soon, and when he gets there, he's going to be playing against guys who are way older than him, and they don't care that he's 23 years old and they're 30 or they're 33. They don't care. They want to beat him. They want to play hard against him. So for him to learn that now against guys way older, way stronger, way bigger, way more experienced, I think the end result of Dovar's game is going to make him a way more complete player. He's sacrificing offense right now, and that's part of it. But we've told him from the beginning that we don't judge him by his offense. We judge him by the hard plays he makes, how competitive he is. If we're losing 4-0, does he get out there and continue to try to build momentum in the game and play hard and to learn? And he's done that. So this is a young man that I know I wasn't getting up at 7 o'clock in the morning when I was 17 years old to come on the ice when no one's there just to work on his game. So he's a very, as you're going to see in a couple minutes, he's a very articulate, very bright young man. No question in my mind that this guy is going to be a professional. Whatever team ends up drafting him is going to be very lucky, because that's the type of guy that we know in 2-3 years, this is going to be Dovar's team. And we know it's going to be the same for him on his professional journey too. So for him, I guess to answer the question in a way roundabout way, is for him playing against a team that's heavy in heart, he wants that. He wants that because he knows that their biggest and their strongest are going to make him harder. They're going to make him tougher. They're going to make him a more complete player. So when he does get to the NHL and he's got Brent Burns pinching down on him and trying to get a puck off him off the half wall, and Brent's got 30 pounds on him, then he's going to have a little bit more experience to go back to and draw from.
Coach, looking ahead to Maine, obviously they're going to be pretty hungry for their first win of the season too, so they're going to come out hard. What are some things that you saw from the Providence series that you want the guys to continue?
That's a great question, Ange. Like the game that we played in game one against Providence was our most complete. And I think there that Providence didn't really know what to expect from us. And then we came out and we had an excellent game again. We were very hard to play against that game. It was very difficult for Providence to get to their game. For the second game against Providence, they knew more about us. And I personally don't feel that Providence really beat us that game. We actually beat ourselves. Our mistakes ended up being mistakes that had a huge cost. They were goals against. They stayed true to their game, and they're an excellent, well-coached, strong, structured team. I think the lessons we can get for that is if we don't stray from our structure, we will have success. Success doesn't always just mean wins. Of course, we all want the wins 100%. I want that first win more than anybody. But we understand there's a long view here too. So the points that we're not getting, when we get into the spring and it's playoff time, we're actually in the playoffs. So we're building towards the game we want to have year after year after year. We want to be a team that is known for playing hockey in April. It's known for playing hockey in late March and into April, because then you're a playoff team. So I think the first real step we took was that game against Providence. We had great periods and great game against Northeastern, for example. Our second game against UMass was very good. We strung together maybe 8, 12 excellent periods, but now we have to do it for 6 periods this weekend right away. And if it goes into overtime and into shootouts, we got to find a way to win. I think the scars that we're getting right now are helping us get there.
You know, again, obviously you're looking for that first win, and, you know, a lot of what you just mentioned. Do you also sometimes go into each game, especially maybe, of course, this Friday, for example, is it a shift by shift thing? Is it a period by period thing? Is there a small pieces that you're, you know, looking to get together to complete the full 60 minutes?
Well, yeah, I think, Ken, that you actually almost answered the question yourself there. Like, we have to win every shift. So if you break it down to its full simplicity, that's how you win. If you win every shift, you're going to win the game. And think of how many shifts you have in a game, how many games you have in a season. So you got to win a shift, you got to win a period, you got to win a game, and you got to do it over and over and over again. And it's hard. It's really hard to win. And our guys are understanding that now, that what is on the line, you might have to block that shot there. You might have to skate the extra 2 or 3 strides with the puck, take a hit, but still get the puck over the red line so there's not an icing, like we saw with a goal that Andrew Lucas here created against Northeastern. He took the extra 3-4 strides, got over the red line, got the puck deep. That resulted in a goal. So I think that you actually answered it yourself there, Ken, that it is a shift by shift thing. If you can win each shift, and that's hard, that's a hard, hard thing to do, but that's the price of winning.
Anything else for Coach, guys?
I think I got to go see my hairdresser right now. Apparently, it's a new year. I got to get a new look. So happy New Year to everybody! I'll go get Dovar for you, and hope everybody has a happier New Year. I've heard people say.
Happy New Year! Thanks, Coach. Thank you, Coach.
You can just sit down and then just field the questions as they come.
Hey guys, Hope everyone's doing all right.
You as well.
Good.
I'll jump right in. You know, it's no secret that you know, you've probably had almost played more games now this year than, you know, months you've had your driver's license. But how's it feel? You know, a coach just talked about it. You know, as a 17-year-old, you're playing against some guys who are 6-7 years ahead of you. You know, what's it been like these first six or so games for you?
It's been definitely an experience, a different one. Guys are a little bit more mature than me, like physically on the ice. So the first couple of games, I definitely noticed that hits are a little bit harder. But then once you kind of get into things, I think against Northeastern, like I kind of adapted to the speed, adapted to the hitting. And also, I mean, the guys around me have been great in practice. They push me hard day in, day out. Same with the coaches. So I think at first it was kind of a shock. And then after a couple of games, I kind of got into the rhythm of things. And so far it's been going up, so hopefully it stays that way.
What's the mentality of this team been like? Obviously still searching for your first win, but gearing up for Maine.
We know we're right there. It's a little frustrating when games like on Friday, last Friday, they slip away from us when we feel like we've been the better team, but we know we're right there. We know it's just a matter of little things here and there. But we know it's right there, and we just keep pushing day in, day out. So we know it's going to come.
Dovar, what's it like knowing you're the youngest guy in your sport?
Just like every other year, I want to say. I don't really think of it that much. If you're a hockey player, you're a hockey player, regardless of age. I think once you get past a certain level, age doesn't matter. It's not a factor anymore because eventually when you go pro, you'll be playing against guys that are 40. So I think at some point you stop thinking about that. And growing up with an older brother, he kind of taught me that once I hit around 14. So yeah, I don't really think about it. I mean, they've helped me on and off the ice, my teammates, and they might know a little bit more than me, or they do know a little bit more than me because they're older. But on the ice, I just think you're a hockey player, and we just play hockey. So
what's the most important thing that you think you helped bring to this team, you know, as obviously through the first couple of games and now moving forward as well, of course?
That's a good question, actually. I think I've brought a maturity in some ways. I think I've brought poise, kind of not getting rattled, let's say, after a goal is scored. I've also tried to, you know, keep the guys like upbeat on the bench, not get too down after a goal. And also just my work ethic in practice or in the morning before practice, you know, I get to the rink, do what I have to do, watch video with attention, little things like that. I think some of the guys have noticed as well. So I kind of, by doing so, I think other guys do chip in. And then it kind of goes around the team like that. So
what have been some of the challenges and difficulties you've faced, you know, whether it's on the ice, off the ice, since you've made the transition to college?
Off the ice, I would say moving away from home. I've always lived from home, so this is the first time that I've been away. And plus with all the COVID and the border complications, I haven't been able to see my parents or my sister or even my dogs. So I kind of, it was kind of a, not a big blow, but a sudden blow for me. I'm not being able to see my parents, let's say, after practice or after games. And then also just not being home in general. I think that was a big blow. But I mean, being with my brother, that helps a lot. And like I said, the guys here are amazing. So that helps. That really helped me kind of get settled. And then on the ice, I would say the first couple of weeks, I would say almost of practice, the speed was a lot higher than junior. Guys hit harder, pucks were moving faster. I think those were kind of the biggest adjustments I had to make. And then once I kind of got into the flow of things, I feel like I adjusted well. And right now I feel like I'm right there with the other guys. Like I said, I don't see myself as a 17-year-old playing with older guys. I just see myself as a hockey player on the ice.
You mentioned you were close this past weekend, obviously, especially on Friday. You know, what's it going to take to, Maine also playing for their first win? What's it going to take for someone to hopefully first pick up that first W? Hopefully it's you guys.
I think it's just a matter of executing, whether it's on the power play or just in zone in general, offensive zone. Like I said, we feel like we're right there. We know we're right there. I think it's going to come down to little details at the end of the day. Like our coach always says, it'll be like a matter of inches of getting the puck in deep right at the red line, or just, driving the net, stuff like that. We know it's not going to be like a 7-4 game or something like that. We know that, or we're expecting it to be like a 3-2, a 2-1 kind of game. And we're comfortable with that. So I think it's just a matter of time until we finally put one in and keep it. So.
What's been the best advice Coach Woodcroft's given you so far?
There's a lot of advice he's given me, and it's all been helpful. But I would say it would be like the matter of offensive production. Growing up, I've always kind of been one of the guys. I've always been like there on the score sheet. And coming here, obviously, it's a little bit different. It's a great league. It's a hard league to play in. And then also, do I just skip these?
Yeah. Sorry about that. You can just have to click away.
Oh, sorry about that.
No, you're good.
Sorry about that, guys. But I would, like I said, it was probably the offensive production, not worrying about that. And just really focusing on your entire game. I think, since I've come here, I've developed so much in so many aspects of the game because of his advice. And I think that just I've become a lot more of a full player, like a whole player, if that makes sense, in all aspects of the game. So I think like his advice about like not worrying about the offensive production, that it'll come, and trusting that'll come, I think that's it's definitely stuck out for me.
Anything else for Dovar, guys?
I'm just thinking about the offense. I'm guessing it's probably a little weird. This is probably like the longest like scoreless streak you've had.
I'm not sure, honestly. I couldn't tell you that. I haven't really thought of it like that.
Yeah.
I've kind of taken it game by game, shift by shift almost. Like I said, I know it's a hard league to score in, especially as a young guy. And, we haven't been winning games. Like I said, like we haven't been scoring, or in games that have been like 7-4, whatever. It's been like 1-0, 2-1, stuff like that, 3-2. So I think it's just trusting kind of the process and knowing that by doing the right things on the defensive end, and not like turning the puck over at the blue line or getting it past the red line, putting it in deep. I think just by trusting that you keep doing that, then eventually, you'll get your chance. And when you do get your chance, just make sure that you put it in the back of the net. So
thank you.
Thank you, guys.